Alrighty, welcome back to Nickelodeon's Comic Corner, Classics That's Non-Classics. This is episode number 1791, and double shot number 1685. We're now moving past the bad stuff, we're on to good stuff. First up, now both these books basically have tie-ins loosely to the crossover that came out last year, King in Black. This is... First up, it is a book I reviewed the trade for this in a while. Savage Avengers, Volume 4, King in Black. Collecting issues 17 to 22. And there's one more trade left to go after this one before the book. The book actually ended last year. This run in after 28 issues. I was wondering, would they cancel the book? No, they restarted it. But here's the thing I do like about it. They didn't basically release the first issue a week after the previous issue came out, or like a month. First issue actually came out this month. Yep. This issue's here. It's basically Conan doing various team-ups. First person he teams up with is freaking Deadpool. Awesome! And this is after his book got canceled. Yep. After his book got freaking canceled. Which I wonder, why the heck would you cancel a good book? Yeah, by the way, the issues, still by Gary Duggan, artwork by Keb Walker, who does issues pretty much 17, 19, and then the last three of the web, Patch Zercher. Mm-hmm. The cover is by Valerio Grimnino and Frank Damiglia. Yep. Yeah, first issue, 17, it's a tie-in to King in Black. Yep. I think it's the only issue to tie into King in Black, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. I think it was this issue and maybe the following issue tied into King in Black. Yeah. Oh, wait. Okay. Yeah, starting with basically back with issue only basically 1719. Yeah, and also these issues, they basically brought back the character Slither Priest after he'd been dead not that long. I mean, he got killed off in issue 15 and he's brought back five issues later. Mm-hmm. Yep. So basically Conan's arrested for defending himself, and though he's broken out by Deadpool. It is so fun. Have seen him with a freaking Deadpool in these issues. It is so fun. We have flashbacks of Conan basically in past. Basically, he's talking to a sword. And more Stoic King in Black is so awesome. And that's only issue 16. 17, for some strange reason, I'm not really sure how this is. Like, after Stoic King in Black, he somehow ends up at the Hellfire Club. Yes, the Hellfire Club. Yes, the abandoned branch in New York City. Which is so hilarious, the fact he ended up here. Like, you're probably thinking, wait, when was the last time this building was seen? Like, prior to this very issue? Well, let me answer that question for you, because it is quite something. Let's see. The last time I showed up prior to this was in Giant Size Phantom X number 1. Which came out the year prior. We're like, okay, how about an ongoing series? The final issue of... with exception of a one-shot, this first part of a few years. Heck, this building popped up issues of New Avengers. Yeah, New Avengers of all places. And after these couple issues, popped up issue 21, popped up three more times after that, and that's it for the Hellfire Club mansion. It's so funny. Yeah, like, how the heck did Deadpool even know about the Hellfire Club? Oh, wait, he's a fourth wall breaking character. Of course, he's like that. So, Deadpool, of course, he runs into the Marauders because, well, my guess is the reason why Gary Duncan threw in the Marauders is just because he writes Marauders at this point, though he left Pope books to write main X-Men. Yep, and to beat the crap out of frickin' Iceman, who I was a frost giant. Yes, a frost giant. I mean, looking here on the cover, looks like he's fighting a venom-possessed Cyclops. Nope, he does do that. The cover's a lie. Yeah, he's fighting the Marauders. And after that, he ends up spending the night at... Actually, always Cyclops. Okay, he is possessed by... Okay, so that wasn't a lie. So, then pretty much after that, he ends up spending the night at the Hellfire Club. Like, yay, spend the night there. And then, of course, goes to a bar, runs to the Rhino. By the way, issue 20, he ends up with Spider-Man. Yes, Spider-Man of all people, which is awesome. Like, how'd you find me? Yes. And... yeah, works in for one issue. It seems strange, though, that Conan with team would help people. Spider-Man. Yeah, it seems a little strange. And here we have Sickle Piece resurrected by Colin Girth. Mm-hmm. If I get back to Hellfire Club Mansion, where basically Conan's waked up, and apparently he has himself a three-way with two women. Yep, puts a robe on, Sarah's painting up Sebastian Shaw, and then Emma Frost shows up. Yes, Emma Frost. Don't get up, please. I know you know the extraction here anyway, but I am the White Queen Heifer Club. Mr. Conan, nice to meet you. It was undecided whether to throw you out, I'll be honest, or warm me up to what you're doing to the old place. And your friend Logan asked me a favor. She is Logan, too. Why would she refer to him as his friend? She knows him, too. I mean, she practically slept with Cyclops. Not really sure why Gary Duggan writes it this way for. It's kind of weird. Yes, favor, so. Now, come see her, woman. Release me, damn witch. Yes, he called Emma Frost, who's using telekinesis on him, calls her a witch. Yeah, then all of a sudden, after we had the freaking Ghost Rider show up. Yes, this is Johnny Blaze Ghost Rider. Yeah, he's here. And then he pops back in the past, Aquila, briefly. And then he's back in the present. Yep, he's back to the present. And then he runs a Nightmare. Yep, a popular Steve character. Mm-hmm. And he's seen his old man. A little Nightmare stuff. And then, basically, he runs to Doctor Strange again. Where he runs into Simon Girth. Yeah, a creature who recently found out here. This book is awesome. I still love this series. 10 out of 10. Really awesome. Alright, next up is more King of Black Avengers stuff. Yes, a King of Black Avengers book. Oddly enough, I don't think there was any main issues of Avengers tied into King of Black. I don't remember if any did. Let's see, for Avengers, one issue did. One. Issue 45. And this pretty much in a way is like all the one-shots. Most of them anyways. Mm-hmm. There's only one-shots, King of Black Avengers. We have Black Panther, Captain America, Ghost Rider, Immortal Hulk, Iron Man slash Doctor Doom, and Wiccan and Hulkling. Now, I should point out though, the Hulk book, excuse me, is done by Al Ewing, who was the writer of the book, and Ghost Rider is also done by his regular ongoing series writer, Ed Bronson. As for the other books, Black Panther, Jeffrey Thorne, Captain America, David Lauren, that's interesting, they could bring in the regular writer for this one, okay. You have Christopher Chanwell, that's interesting, doing the Iron Man slash Doc Doom book, and Hulkling, Wiccan Hulkling is Tina Howard, who, from a lot of people I know, don't like her very much because, well... because of something she's doing for the X-Men books now that a lot of people don't like very much. Mm-hmm. Wiccan Hulkling is simply put basically these two on their honeymoon on a planet, which is kind of like Ryza from Star Trek, and they're there with Captain Marvel's half-sister, who's in a bikini, which I found to be so hilarious. I mean, here's the big hulking brute that is Captain Marvel's sister, and she's in a bikini. I found it to be so funny. And she's there with two guys who are gay. Though, here's the thing. No, she's doing anything to them at all. Basically, Yeah, it is so hilarious. The Black Panther one is, simply put, the symbiote's invading Wakanda, and Black Panther doing his awesome, basically fend out the invasion, similar to what happened to Secret Invasion, which is awesome. Now, as for the other one shots in here, the Captain America one. It's mostly what Cap, Bucky, and Cap, Winter Soldier, and Falcon up to during the whole thing. And then basically fighting stuff off. Oh yeah, and also working with, of all people, let's see if we can find a picture here. I saw somebody. No, just like these three. Just fighting up the invasion for the whole story. Fighting Kalth, and that was it. Ghost Rider, basically, when he's fighting freaking dragons. Yep. We also have freaking Blackheart pop up here. Yes, Blackheart is fighting aliens, which that's interesting. He's a freaking demon. He's fighting alien dragons, which is so awesome. Yep. Immortal Hulk, it's simply a weak Hulk on Black Christmas fighting dragons. It's mostly a silent issue. And this is how Hulk looks in this book. He's like skinny. Yeah, this happened toward the end of the Al Ewing run. He can get back there with no problem. Yeah, it's a great issue. Iron Man Hulk, it's input Iron Man helping Dr. Infinite and Vince Latveria from the King of Black Stuff. And it's a Christmas issue. Yes, it's a Christmas issue featuring the King of Black Stuff, which is so fun. Oh, and if you want to see Captain Marvel's sister in a swimsuit. Here you go. There you go. Captain Marvel's sister in a swimsuit. I thought that was so funny. Yep, and then fighting dragons and yeah. Fun stuff here. Love it. The artwork for this stuff here. I should give credit for these people. For Black Panther, Germán Padilla. The Captain America was done by at least four different artists. Marco Kurluk, Steve Linney, Rug Leo, and Neil Luyan. Ghostwriter. I'm sorry for mispronouncing the names. Juan Ferri. Aaron Carter does the Immortal Hulk one. Dr. Doom. Aramis does Dr. Doom. Sabra LaRocca. Which is actually, this is actually better artwork than he's normally done in Star Wars. And Lucino Fajito. Yep. Fun stuff here. Collects mostly the one shots. Doesn't collect the Spider one for some reason. I think it's collecting one of the Arrow trades for related to King of Black stuff. I give this book a 9 out of 10. Really good. Okay. And now I'm out of trades. Yep. In case you're curious though, is there any more King of Black trades left? Yeah, is there like any officially left? For trades wise, well, there's still some left. Let's see. I viewed the main event, this book, Planet of the Symbiotes, Thunderbolts, Gwen vs. Scrunch, that's where you find the King of Black Spider, which I think is now. I have pretty much reviewed all of the one shots related to King of Black. Yep, I think so. So these are the ones left to go that I have not reviewed yet. Namor. Atlantis Attacks. Symbiote Spider-Man King in Black. And that's it. Just those two. Actually, three. It's basically just miniseries. But yeah, I think I reviewed most of everything related to King in Black. Yeah, the only book I don't own is... Oh yeah, I almost forgot. There's Namor, Return of the Valkyries, Symbiote Spider-Man King in Black, Atlantis Attacks. That's it. Just four trades left. But, yeah, I think I own pretty much almost all these trades. I'm looking at it right now. There's no trade I don't own for King Black. Yeah. But, yeah, I've pretty much viewed most of this event so far, which is awesome. I love it. Yeah, I'm getting closer and closer to get this whole thing reviewed. One, I don't know if it's in trade. It's the group, the Union. Yep. Yeah, I don't know if in fact I get a chance to review if there's actually a trade for this one. I don't really remember. There probably is. I don't know. If there is, I'll probably get a chance to review at some point. Yep. But yeah, that's pretty much it for second review, and that's gonna be it for videos tonight. So, tomorrow. Is there any videos coming tomorrow? One I can think of, and that's going to be Rise of the Shield Hero. Okay? Next video. Bye.